She has such a rejuvenating effect in the body that you reverse back to your natural hair color. I think it's powerful. That's why we did it. Now, in the scientific literature, you've seen it in the press, a lot of people are talking about how stem cells could be the cause of cancer. Answering that question with arguments would not really lead us anywhere, so we did a study. Very simple study to just clear the whole question. We inoculated mice with human breast cancer cells, and then we split the group in two, and then one group we gave control, nothing, or a placebo, and the other group we gave steminins. Now, three things can happen. Stem cells or steminins, by increasing the number of stem cells, these stem cells can migrate in the tumor and promote tumor growth, so we could have increased tumor growth. We could have no effect whatsoever, or we could have a decrease, because one thing that people don't really talk about is that when stem cells get into a tissue and they proliferate and then they stop proliferating, they release compounds that calms all the neighbors around to sort of stop the proliferation process. Now we're done. We have repaired the tissue, it's time to stop. So they could also, through that process, suppress tumor growth. So we could have these three options. So we did the study, and as you can see on this graph, after 6 weeks, we had a 30% reduction in the growth of the tumor. Now, that study was not made to determine if steminins has anti-tumor properties. So that conclusion I cannot make. But what we can clearly make out of this study is that steminins, or releasing stem cells from the bone marrow, do not promote in any way tumor growth. If anything, it prevents it. Okay, the last one that I want to talk about is a study on fitness. Many people start to talk about how, from a physical performance standpoint, started to report much better performance. And we have our notorious case, Frank Condon. You may have heard the story. Frank had his own record when he was 57, and he could not change it for a number of years. At 63, if I remember well, started to take stem enhance, and then beat his 57 years old record. If I remember well, it was by many seconds. I think it was 10 seconds. He's doing like the 1,000 meters, 1.5 kilometers, long distance, not the dash, but not the marathon, somewhere in between. There was a video on the web of one of his races. It was very impressive. You see the racetrack, and then you see Frank crossing the line, you know, the finish line, and in the background, half a field behind, you see the rest of the people running behind. It was fairly impressive. So at 63, he beat his record at 57. At 64, he beat his record at 63. And at 65, he beat his record at 64. That was after an injury that was supposed to put him off for the rest of the season. He just repaired very fast, went back, and beat his record again. So a lot of people start to report those kinds of stories. So there's a process here. When you push your body a lot, you break muscle fibers. When these muscle fibers are broken, there's a mechanism to protect the muscle that is inherent to your nervous system so that you're not going to overcontract that muscle and further damage it. So if the damage is fine, like it's not huge, a little bit soreness, but not more, you go back the day after and you train again. But you cannot train to the fullest because there is an inherent mechanism to prevent to go to full contraction. If you can repair much faster and recover faster, 2 days later, when you go back to the gym, you can go to the fullest. 3 days later, 5 days later, and so on every day. So over time, you just get a much greater outcome out of your same training. That was the concept. So we went in the lab and we tested it. When we started to talk about the study, and we tell them, we'll put you on steminins, they started to look at steminins, what it was, and when they slowly realized what steminins was, we could not have any one of them on placebo. They said, if I'm not on steminins, I'm not part of that study. So we were not able to have like a placebo group and a steminins group. So we tried to think of how can we work that in so that we can clearly see the effect of steminins compared to the effect of the training. So what we did is that we split the group in two. One group started on steminins on day one, and the other group started a month later. So if there was a difference, we would have the first group progress faster and the other group reach them up in their progress a little bit later. And that's exactly what we saw. You can see the group one here progressed much faster, and then group two, as soon as they started to get on steminins after about week four, week five, then they slowly reached back the other group. So we're using that data as preliminary data because it's strictly preliminary data at this point, but we're using this to basically go now and sponsor large study in a lab that has that very specific expertise. So that's the body of the information that I wanted to share about STEMinence. What it does in the body, how we've proven the concept through various research, and what has happened outside of what we have done throughout the entire scientific research, what other labs have done. This is, again, a powerful, powerful phenomenon that is called to change the way that we're looking at health and wellness. I see it just 2, 3, 4, 5 years down the road. The message that will be out there in health and wellness is that, yes, many things that we're doing is good for health, and we continue to do them. But the primary thing to do to maintain health is just to support that natural renewal system in the body every day. What it is that I think a lot of health problem that we experience is actually a deficiency, a lack in the stem cells to do simply their day-to-day job. If we do not rebuild, compensate for this every day, at the same speed as they go down, health problems show up down the road. And that is the cause of an awful lot of unwellness in human life. Once we understand this and we just support this natural renewal system in the body, it's going to totally change the way that we look at health and wellness. So, thank you very much.